today is gonna be a good day. Yesterday I received a text from my friend Hoagy asking me if I want to fly with him today. Yes sir, I'm on my way to the airport, but not your typical airport. The airport where Hoagy has his plane, and it's a special plane, not your typical plane either. It's an aerobatic plane. And Hoagy is a pretty damn good pilot, so I trust him with my life. We're gonna do some barrels, some rolls, some crazy stuff, so stay tuned. I'm gonna share that with you guys. We are here with Hoagy, my friend's Hoagy.
Hi.
So when did you start to fly? I think you started really young.
I started flying at first when I was about 12 years old. I didn't have any pilots in my family, but I was just obsessed with
12
airplanes.
12 years old? I didn't remember that.
A couple of flying lessons when I was young. And then when I moved out to California in the mid-90s, I had a real job so I could afford to get a pilot's license. So I started flying for fun. I got my pilot's license. And then I decided to become an airline pilot. So I worked in, I was an art director in an advertising agency in San Francisco, and then I got kind of bored of that. I didn't want to sit at a desk anymore, so I actually went to the airlines and started flying a big jet, and that was a terrible career choice. So I left that, started making video games, and now I fly this thing for fun.
That's awesome. So tell us more about these things. So Starduster?
Yeah, so this was a very popular kit airplane from the 1960s and 1970s. It's called the Starduster II, and it's spelled T-O-O because the original Starduster was only one passenger. So the guy that designed it was a guy named Lou Stolp.
Okay.
And when he made the Starduster to carry two people, he decided to call it the Starduster T-O-O.
Was it French? Like, you didn't know how to spell two?
No, it's just you can bring somebody two.
Okay.
Plus somebody else two. So anyway, that's the joke. But it's a wonderful, easy handling biplane. We can do some kind of minor acrobatics in it. And I love flying it. So this particular one was built in, was started in 1969. A husband and wife couple up in Washington worked on it together. And apparently they worked on it after dinner every night for 4 years. And they finished it in 1973. And then they flew it a little bit and sold it. And it's been owned by, I don't know, six or seven different people over the years.
Wow, what's the engine on that?
So this has a Lycoming. It's a flat four cylinder engine. It's an 0320. That means it's hosed cylinders, 320 cubic inches. It's about 160 horsepower.
Cool.
Not a ton of horsepower, but the airplane is really light.
It's got a lot of wings. 1,000 pounds.
About 1,100 pounds empty, so it doesn't need that much power.
Can't wait to fly that. Let's go.
We're going
to
do it.
Thank you, buddy.
That was really great.
We are live. We are live.
What a flight. What a flight. That was awesome. It was all the roller coasters in the world. At some point, we took 4 Gs, and I think the plane can take up to 6 or 7 Gs. So virtually, you can take like 6 or 7 times your weight. That's unbelievable. So thank you, Hoagy, for that. Really appreciate it. And thank you guys for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. If so, please subscribe, comment, like, and see you in the next one.